Morning class. I am here to start a new topic today, that is welfare. Yesterday we saw the concept of wealth, we saw the meaning, characteristics and the forms of wealth. Now wealth is an important aspect before you understand the welfare topic. That is why we came across the wealth concept yesterday, and the wealth is followed by welfare. Now when I say wealth is followed by welfare, I mean to say when you own a wealth, when you have a wealth, when you have money, when you have income, that means the welfare will follow. Now what does welfare mean? In a literal sense, in a layman's term, welfare means well-being of a person or a society or a group of individuals. Welfare means well-being of a person, a society or a group of individuals. Okay. But in economics, there is a further division of welfare. Like in economics, the welfare is categorized into two different units. One is economic welfare, the other is non-economic welfare. So our subject or our syllabus would confine to economic welfare only. We are not bothered about non-economic welfare, but I will give you a small introduction about this event. Economic welfare we are concerned about, we should talk about, because being a student of economics, being a part of economics, we must know the economical aspect of every topic that we deal. Every deal will be in the terms of monetary only. Money has to be there, because money is an important aspect, is the center of the core aspect, the center of attraction, which actually all the schemes, all the plans, all the topics revolve around. So economical aspect has to be taken care when we deal about the welfare. Now it is said that when wealth is accumulated, when wealth is owned by a person, the welfare follows up. Try to get this, what I mean to say. When you have the wealth with you, when you have the money with you, the welfare will automatically follow. This is what the economists try to explain. They are trying to explain over here, when your economical aspect is good, when you have a good economical background, or your economical, your earnings is good, your income sources are good, your welfare would be the most satisfied. Now, according to this philosophy, all the persons, all the richest persons of this planet, be it Bill Gates, Mukesh Ambani, we have Ratan Tata, all these people would be the most happiest person on this planet. They would not be having any complaints, any difficulties with life. Does it sound okay on a practical ground? Do you feel that this Ratan Tata would not be having any problem in life? Mukesh Ambani and Anil Ambani would not be having any problems in life. Bill Gates would be the most happy person. Bill Gates and Melinda Gates, they would be the most happiest person on this planet. They might be having certain difficulty. The difficulty would not surround according to economic aspect, but there would be something which would come under or fall under the concept of non-economic concept. So welfare follows up the wealth, that is true. But every time it does not stand true. You have to understand. There is a question on this. Is this myth or is it true that welfare is followed by wealth? When you have the wealth, welfare will follow. Is it okay up to one extent? But there are certain limitations to it. There are certain other sides of the coin as well, which you need to know. Other sides is that a mental satisfaction is the utmost requirement when you consume, when you come across any product. Your satisfaction should match up with the dire need of the product. Whenever a product you consume, from the consumer point of view, whenever you consume a product, you should be satisfied first. When you are working in a particular place, your working environment should be supporting. Your wages, your salary should be supporting. Then only you can work, you can give your 100%. When the salary amount or when the payment amount is not good enough, you will not perform. So economical aspect talks about when a person is accumulated with wealth, he is said to be the most happiest person. On one aspect, on one ground, it is okay. it is not only the concept. The wealth is not only the concept which will give you the utmost satisfaction or entire satisfaction. There are other sides of the coin too. The other sides are that mental satisfaction should be generated at any cost without any hindrances. Like, we all know that industrial revolution took place in the year, in the mid of 17th century in England. The industrial revolution took place in the mid of 17th century. Now, industrial revolution, if I talk about the exact period, it was 1760 to 1820. This is what the period I remember. Industrial revolution, which began from England. Now, this was believed to a milestone step, which actually brought a tremendous changes into the life and lifestyle and the type of the economical background that the people belong to England. It was a milestone step which actually brought a tremendous change into their lives. The whole of the economy got became progressive one, from a developing to a developed economy they became, and they ruled over the world. The colonial rulers or the Britishers ruled to different countries. We were even the one who once were slave of the Britishers. They actually began the industrial revolution from England, followed by USA, then Europe, and then to the different parts of the world. Now, the thing is, what I want to say about here, that it's okay that industrial revolution brought a tremendous change. They increased their stock of income, and there was a sound progress in the England. What happened to the people or the human welfare or the human assets who worked day and night for the promotion of wealth, for the accumulation of wealth, but they lost their own happiness? In what way? They accumulated the wealth, that is okay from the economical background, from the economic concept, but they lost their happiness. Extra amount of work were performed by them, they devoted extra time, but at the same time, they did not receive a good working condition, good wages, good environment, which actually degraded the life of their own. Means their lifestyle was improved, but their own health was deteriorated. If you earn money and you have to invest in your health, then that is not an income. That is not an income. That would not be called as wealth. We call it health. Health is wealth. How is this proverb true? When you are losing your health, not to accumulate wealth. So a balance should be there. Working conditions, working environment should be friendly. This is what happened in England. The people were earning, but the environment or the working conditions were not suitable, which actually created a lot of mental problems, health problems, and they lost their economical aspects. So, on one ground, it is true that economic welfare is concerned with wealth, but at the same time, the non-economic area or non-economic point should not be left out. Non-economic talks about the mental satisfaction or the satisfaction which you derive when you consume a particular product. That satisfaction should be there. In order to be in line, or to be intact, there should be a particular level of satisfaction which you should achieve when you consume a particular good and services. Okay, so this is all about the welfare, which you must know. Welfare is a concept which actually follows up with the wealth. I just have a small introduction about the next topic is capital. What is capital? All those man-made goods which are used for further production, all the goods and services that you see around is produced by the human beings only. All the inventions that you see, all the machinery that you see have been developed, all the different buildings, the 3D architect cars or vehicles are developed today. All these are used by the human minds only. So all the developments which help in the further production or which help to reduce the time limit, which makes your work easier, is capital for you. From the business point of view, from the commerce point of view, you need to understand what is capital. All those things which help you out to perform your work in the most beneficial method or in the better way is capital for you. Capital need not only mean the amount of money, the cash in hand, the monetary aspect, the rupee. That is not only capital. The capital has to be all the machinery, the buildings, the assets, the human welfare, the human values. All these are part of capital only. Everything that makes you work easier, that makes you work perfect, is a capital for you. When you own a capital, it does not merely mean the cash in hand, but the machineries, the buildings, the assets, the land, everything is a capital for you. If you think from the production line, a thing which helps to fulfill your work or which makes your work easier, which helps you out to perform your work on an easier scale, is a capital for you. Okay, the capital has to be one which fulfills all your wishes, which makes your work easier, or which reduces the human effort. Human effort has to be minimized and maximum work has to be taken from the machineries or the building or the raw materials. So everything that helps you out to fulfill your needs, to fulfill your production units, that is the capital. So I'll put a stop over here, and next class we shall discuss about the types of capital. Thank you, guys.